At 5 years old, I was putting my baby sister's diapers on her. I saw her vagina. I wanted one. I wanted one. I thought it was great.
I thought I was open. I ate to belong. I ate to smell like my mother. Her sweet aroma lived in my hair and on my hands and in my skin. I ate to be pretty. Pretty.
I wondered, why I was missing my bathing suit top at the beach? Why I was never dressed like all the other girls? I ache to be completed. I ache to belong. To twirl the baton.
They assigned me sex the day I was born. It's as random as being adopted or as being assigned a hotel room on the 30th floor. It has nothing to do with who you are or your fear of heights. But in spite of the apparatus that I was forced to carry around, I always knew that I was a girl.
They beat me for it. They beat me for crying. They pummeled me for wanting.
To touch.
To pat.
To hug.
To help.
To hold their hands.
For trying to fly around the church like Sister Betrayal.
For doing cartwheels.
For crocheting socks.
For carrying purses to kindergarten.
They kicked the shit out of me every day on my way to school.
In the park, they smashed my magic marker painted nails.
They punched my lipstick mouth. They beat the girl out of my boy.
Or so they tried.
So I went underground. I quit them too.
Be a man. Stand up for yourself. Go punch him back.
I grew a full beard.
It was good I was big.
I joined Marines. Suck it up and drive home.
I became dollar.
Jaded.
Sometimes cruel.
Butch it up.
Always clenched, inaccurate, and incomplete. I ran away from home.
From school.
From boot camp.
Ran to my aunt.
Greenwich Village.
Aleutian Islands.
No.
Wilderness lesbians. Got my first hormone shot. Got permission to be myself.
Permission to transition, to travel, to immigrate. 350 hours of hot needles. I would count the male particles as they died. 16 man hairs gone.
The feminine is in your face. I raise my eyebrows more. I'm curious. I ask questions.
And my voice? Practice, practice. It's all about resonance. La 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 la. Men are my turn of class. Southern accents are really excellent. Jewish accents are really great. Hello, my friend.
And my vagina is so much friendlier now. I cherish it. It brings me joy.
The orgasms come in waves. Before, they were jerky.
I'm the girl next door.
My lieutenant colonel father ended up paying for it. My vagina. My mother was worried. What they would think of her. That they made this happen. Until one day I came to church and everyone said, "You have a beautiful daughter."
I'm allowed to be soft. I'm allowed to listen. I'm allowed to question. I am able to receive.
To be in the present tense.
People are so much nicer to me now.
A wrong was righted.
I'm right with God.
It's like when you're trying to sleep and there's this loud car alarm. When I got my vagina, it was like somebody finally turned it off.
I live now in the female zone. She don't think to say about immigrants. They don't like it when you come from someplace else. They don't like it when you mix. They killed my boyfriend. They beat him insanely while he slept. With a baseball bat. They beat this girl out of his head. What a day before. Even though she was pretty, and even though she listened, even though she was kind, I didn't want him falling in love with ambiguity. And with that, terrified of love.